In this video, let's look at the Redmi Note 7 Pro's some of the settings, some of the interesting settings that Redmi Note 7 Pro has to offer. I have already made several videos about the Redmi Note 7 as well as Redmi Note 7 Pro. If you are new to my channel, click on that subscribe button and do watch my videos for more interesting content. And also, I have made several videos about the mobile photography in general, so that may interest you as well. So the first feature we are going to look at is the About Phone. So just go to the About Phone here. Now inside, you will find this kernel version. So just keep tapping on this kernel version 5 times. And here you have the CIT test. So this is the FQC test. Basically, you can test if your mobile is working properly or not. So there are various aspects here. As you can see, you can check the voice back camera, you can check the master back camera, you can check the OTG plugin, if proximity sensor is properly working or not, magnetic sensor, gyroscope, GPS, FM. So there are pretty much everything that if your mobile is having any issues, you can right away go here and basically test if it is working properly or not. So if I just tap on LED, for example, if I just tap on backlight LED, so it checks for if it is working or not. As you can see, it is blinking. It also blinks the charging light and tests itself that if it is properly working or not. Similarly, you can test the motor, SD card, SIM test. So there is a lot of things that you can do here and basically ensure that your mobile is working properly. So this is the FQC test actually. So it says if it is passed or failed, depending on which one you are actually testing out there. So the next setting we'll be looking is inside the developer option. So to enable developer option, what you have to do is go to the About Phone here and then keep tapping on the MIUI version. As you can see, if I just keep tapping 5 times, you are now a developer. So now the developer setting is unlocked. Just go to the additional settings here, and here you will be able to find the developer options. So now we are in developer options, and also as you can see, it is right now enabled because I have entered into that. And here there are so many things that you can customize, such as the night mode. You can actually keep the night mode always on. You can automatically schedule it based on time of the day. So as it gets evening, it will change to dark mode. So once we are in developer options here, what you have to do is, so just keep scrolling until you find the animation, or rather animator duration scale. Now just tap on this animator duration scale and change it to 0.5x. So change everything to 0.5x. This way, as you can see, that there is not really much animation over here, and hence you will see that everything runs very, very fast. So whatever I press on here, it just opens up very quickly. You can actually see that, test it yourself, and you'll know what I mean by saying this. Whenever you try to open any applications, as you can see, it doesn't waste much time in actually animating the screen itself. So that way everything becomes fast, really, really fast. As you can see, I can pretty much switch between the applications very, very fast. If you think that you don't need any animation, you can just turn it off. So I would suggest that you keep it to 0.5x. let's say I change it to 5x. Now as you will see that the transition animation, as you can see how slowly it pops up, as you can see, just as a tap. In order to reduce that speed, you just move it to 0.5x. now everything will be damn fast. So do change that and let me know in the comment section down below how quick your mobile has become. So that's a little trick that you can apply in order to get the user interface to perform really fast. So the next feature we'll be looking here is changing the notification and status bar. So let's go to the settings quickly, and here you will find notification and status bar. Now here there is shared shortcut. As you can see here, notification shared shortcut. So what is this is, if I just swipe down like this, what you see here is settings, right? So if I want to quickly go to the settings, I usually swipe down like this and use this settings menu here. So you can also customize this particular setting icon. So in order to do that, let's go to the notification and status bar here, and here you will find this notification shared shortcut. Now I'll change that to search. Now if you want to search anything on this mobile phone, you can just swipe down like this from the top, and here you will see that the search bar is there. Now quickly you can search, you can do a Google search and find information very quickly without having to log into the Google Assistant, or even without having to go to the internet browser. So this is the quickest means that I found. As you can see, just tap on search and start searching right away. So this is a little trick that you can apply to actually search. So if it doesn't interest you, you can always keep that settings things here. Otherwise you can always access your settings right away from here. So guys, the next setting again will we'll be moving to the background process limit, which is located in the developer options. So in order to do that, let's move to the developer options, which is located in additional settings. All the way down, go to the developer options here. Here you'll find background process limit. Now what this basically does is it limits the background processes. Let's say it uses or it consumes a lot of battery and there is a lot of applications running in the background. So how do you actually limit it? So in order to do that, here you'll find background process limit. Usually it is just standard limit. That means how the phone functions, it depends on how the software has been written. Now you can actually, let's say I keep it to at most two processes. Now in even in recent applications, even if you open applications frequently, it will be set to only two process. That means at a given time, only two process will be running in the background, not more than that, saving you battery as well as making your mobile phone perform faster. So this is a little nifty trick. If you like this one, hit that like button. So this is the thing a lot of people don't know. You can actually customize this, change it to at most two or three processes, and boom, there you go, your phone performs much faster than before right now. So these are the settings that I covered in this video. In the next setting, I'm going to talk about more settings about the Redmi Note 7 Pro. Hit that like button if you want to see more. Don't forget to click on that subscribe button, guys. So see you all in another one. Bye bye.